Good morning to all the students. Welcome to the online learning of bookkeeping and accountancy. In the last video, we had seen which are the different types of accounts and statements that are prepared in the partnership final accounts. Today, we will be beginning with the adjustments of final accounts. First of all, we will understand what is the meaning of final adjustments. Adjustments means the information which is given below the trial balance. The details that are detected after all the accounts are closed and the trial balance is prepared are called as the adjustments. These adjustments are given in the form of additional information below the trial balance. As other items of the trial balance, we have to give the effect to these adjustments. But the only thing is that every adjustment will have two effects. The first effect will be either in the trading account or in the profit and loss account. And the second effect will be in the balance sheet, either on the asset side or on the liability side. So, every adjustment is going to have two effects. Now, there are various adjustments which we are going to study. These adjustments will be asked to you in the board exam. There are few adjustments which we have studied in the 11th standard. So, this is a brief and quick revision of the adjustments. These adjustments are compulsorily going to be asked in your board exam paper. The first adjustment is regarding the closing stock. What is a closing stock? Closing stock means the stock available with the businessman on the last day of the accounting year. That means whatever goods are available in your godown on 31st of March, those are considered as your closing stock. Now, these goods may be the goods which are returned by your customers. These goods may be the goods which are damaged, or they might be unsold goods. Whatever may be the reason, these goods are available with you on the last day of the accounting year. Therefore, they will be considered as your closing stock. Now, this closing stock will be recorded at cost or market price, whichever is less. The method of recording the closing stock is, if you are given two prices, one is the cost price, another is the market price, then in that case, we have to consider the price whichever is low. Okay, so we are going to record the closing stock at cost or market price, whichever is less. The two effects of closing stock are, first is on our trading account credit side, and secondly, balance sheet asset side. These are the two effects of closing stock. The second and the most important adjustment is regarding the outstanding expenses. Now, outstanding expenses are those expenses which are related to your current year, but they are remaining unpaid during the year. If you have not paid any of the expenses which are related to the current year, then such expenses become outstanding expenses. They are also called as accrued expenses. Accrued expenses means collected, accumulated expenses. Okay, they are an additional burden on the business in the next year or in the coming month. These outstanding expenses are to be cleared or satisfied by the business in the coming years. The effects of outstanding expenses, the first one is ट्रेडिंग और प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट डेबिट साइड एड टू द ओरिजिनल एक्सपेंस. What type of expense it is, whether it is an direct expense or whether it is an indirect expense, depending upon the type of the expense, we are going to record it in the trading or profit and loss account. And outstanding expenses are to be added to the original expense wherever they appear. Second effect will be on the balance sheet, liability side. These are unpaid, not paid. It is an extra burden on the business in the coming years. Therefore, it is a liability which has to be cleared by the business and recorded on balance sheet liability side. Then, the next adjustment that we come across in the final accounts is outstanding income. Outstanding income is nothing but the income which is due but not received during the year. That means this income is related to the current year. It must have to be received in the current year, but due to some reasons, the income is not received. This type of income is called as the outstanding income. You are likely to receive the income in the coming days or future. So, such type of income is called as an outstanding income, and the effect of outstanding income will be in your profit and loss account credit side. Incomes are recorded on profit and loss account credit side. Therefore, we are going to add the outstanding income on the credit side to the original income. And since we are going to receive this income along with the other regular income in the coming days or in the coming future, then it becomes the asset of the business, and therefore it is recorded on the balance sheet asset side. The next adjustment is regarding the prepaid expenses. Prepaid expenses are those expenses which are paid in advance. They are paid before they are due. So such expenses are called as prepaid expenses. Generally, advertisement, insurance are the examples of prepaid expenses. When we have an adjustment of prepaid expenses, we have to give the effect to the prepaid expenses in trading or profit and loss account debit side. Now, since it is an expense, it will be recorded on profit and loss account debit side, less from original expense. Always remember, prepaid expenses are to be deducted from the original expense. And secondly, it is recorded on balance sheet asset side. The next adjustment that we come across is pre-received income. Pre-received, that means income which is received before it is due. Before it is actually due to be received. Such income is called as income received in advance or pre-received income. The effect of pre-received income will be on the profit and loss account credit side, less from original income. And secondly, it will be recorded on balance sheet liability side. Suppose if we are entering into a rent agreement, payment of 11 month rent in advance to the owner, that is an example of pre-received income. For the owner, 11 months rent is received in advance. It is received before it is due. Therefore, it will be deducted from the profit and loss account credit side and it will be shown on the balance sheet liability side. The next adjustment that we had seen in our last year's syllabus, that is depreciation. What is depreciation? Depreciation means reduction in the value of fixed asset. When the value of the fixed assets gradually decreases due to the continuous use of the asset, it is called as depreciation. Now, this depreciation is a non-monetary loss of the business. It is compulsory for every business to charge depreciation on the fixed assets available with them. The two effects of depreciation are, first one, profit and loss account debit side, and second effect, we have to reduce the depreciation from the assets on balance sheet asset side. The next adjustment is relating to the debtors. This is reserve for doubtful debts. Out of the total debtors, there might be some debtors who are defaulters. They might not pay the amount due to the business. In such a case, the business may suffer the loss. In order to overcome the loss, in order to compensate the loss arising from the bad debts, business creates a reserve, and that reserve is called as RDD. This reserve has got two effects. One is profit and loss account debit side, and secondly, this reserve is to be deducted from the value of sundry debtors which is available from on the balance sheet asset side. These are the adjustments which we had studied in our last year's final accounts. Out of these adjustments, closing stock, depreciation, RDD, outstanding expenses and prepaid expenses are very important adjustments and they are likely to be asked in your 12th standard also. Now the remaining adjustments like interest on capital, interest on drawings, all these adjustments we will see in our next video. Till then, thank you all of you. Keep watching the videos.